starch agar plate in which you can see the lawn formation. And now we are going to check the presence of the starch, okay, with the help of iodine. So can you give me iodine, grams iodine, can you give me? Grams iodine? Okay. In case of calcium carbonate agar plate, you have to see the dissolved calcium carbonate, and it will give you clear zone around the colony, so that you can mark class marker. You can mark the colonies in which you can see the clearance. Okay, that is organic acid will dissolve calcium carbonate, and you can see a circular clear zone around the colony of organic acid producing organism. Okay, so because this is soil sample, we can see so many different colonies in which there will be this type of clear zone found. So that is the result of calcium carbonate agar. There are so many organic acid producing bacteria which were present in our natural soil sample, and they have given the clear zone. Now, on the basis of gram staining and morphology, you can also clarify, or you can also identify the organisms which may be gram positive or gram negative, having different type of morphology. Now, then after we will go for Rowlett plate technique. Now, in case of Rowlett plate technique, you can see that it is just like the lawn formation, and in this lawn formation, you will try to see that whether you can get the clear circular area around the colony of antibiotic producing bacteria, okay, and you can mark those colonies with their circular zone. And then after marking them, we will write down the colony characteristics and we will carry out the gram staining to identify the bacteria. Now after identification, we will pick up this colony and transfer it and give the raw culture slant. Okay, and that slant will be preserved for longer time period for further study, like secondary screening or something. Okay, so there are so many beautiful colonies which have produced antibiotic, and they have not allowed surrounding organisms to grow, so they will be clear zone. Okay, that is zone of inhibition. You can see here very nicely in this plate. Now, in case of starch agar plate, we will try to identify the end products, okay, produced by bacteria. So we will add little amount of iodine, and then after we will shake it properly to see the formation of blue color in the plate. Okay, and obviously, because there are so many starch degrading bacteria inside the soil, we will see that there are certain zones which will give you clear area. This clear area indicates that there will be no presence of starch at all, but its structural components or minerals have been formed. Okay, so you can see very nicely that very clear zones are formed around the colonies which have produced the amylase enzyme. Okay, very clear and very nice colonies are there, and you can see mark. Then write down the colony characteristics, and then after you can go for gram staining, and then also you can go for subculturing and get it cured in the form of slant, and you can preserve it for secondary screening. Okay, so that was about starch agar plate and amylase producing bacteria. Now about Wilkins Maria. Now in case of Wilkins method, because we have already diluted our sample and we have started working from the third dilution tube, that is 10^-3, you will not get complete lawn, okay? But some area is empty, and you can see that less number of colonies are there. Now here we will see that we have growth in our Wilkins growth, which we have already inoculated yesterday with Escherichia polyculture. And now this is our Wilkins topograph. Now what we are going to do, we will add only 0.1 ml of E. coli in our Wilkins propagar tube, and then after we will overlay it on the and agar trade is already growth of bacteria from soil sample is there. So now only one drop, it can be done with the pipette or by manually also you can do it by adding it only one single drop from bacterial culture to the Wilkins propagar. And then after, shake it properly and overlay only. This plate we already broke for bacteria. Now this plate is to be kept for again 24 hours at 37 degrees centigrade for getting the confirmation that whether our test organisms can be inhibited by the antibiotics using bacteria from